Rhode Island grows the greatest shellfish on the planet. And we take an enormous amount of pride in being able to say that our oysters come from the Ocean State.
I used to see these guys coming in, and it just was awe-inspiring to see all these quahoggers and the old-time guys that I still look up to. Just the freedom of this job is incredible. You can't describe it very easily, but once it's in you, it's there for life. This is where I belong. This is where I'm staying.
The neat thing was we set out to write a plan, but we actually got a lot done along the way.
The shellfish management plan process opened the doors of communication between the regulatory agencies overseeing shellfishing, the commercial interest, the shellfish, and the recreational harvester.
It's brought a group of individuals together to work on something as a team, and that's what I really liked about this. It was a team effort by a whole lot of different groups of people.
The shellfish management plan enhance the cooperation between industry and agencies and the environmental community. The changes in cooperation are positive.
Knowing that shellfish is something that people enjoy recreationally, quahogs are our most lucrative landing in Narragansett Bay, and that shellfish are important for habitat, getting together and having a strategic plan, a blueprint for how we manage them, how we value them, and how we promote them as a state was really needed, and the Shellfish Management Plan gave us a forum to do that.
I really was pleased at how things have turned out. And we've been able to shine a really bright light on a lot of really positive things, whether it's shellfish restoration, aquaculture, the wild harvests, the cultural aspects of shellfish in our lives, and really brings all that together.
Everyone has a connection to shellfish.
In Rhode Island, you don't need a license to shellfish if you're a resident. It's sort of a birthright as a Rhode Islander. And that was something I hadn't known, and I was really proud of that.
We've got the best tasting shellfish in the world, and so a lot of small farms have grown into big farms, and a lot of these kids are really doing a great job producing some of the finest oysters on the planet, and it really makes me very proud.
I see the shellfish management plan as being able to move us forward and identify how we can restore these fisheries in the state. And that's going to help us economically and environmentally.
I believe my industry, myself, are directly affected by this shellfish management plan. It's given us an ability to now manage our shellfish here in Rhode Island. We have a fish that doesn't move. We've never managed it. Now we can.
Really want to make sure that there are guys out there, wild harvesters and even aquaculturists, so everybody can enjoy what I get to enjoy every day.
It means our bay is going to be clean. It means our shellfish are going to be protected. And if you choose to come out here and do what I do for a living, you can in the future.
The sustainability of the fishery matters to me, but it matters to all Rhode Islanders that we protect and manage this resource correctly, and that it's here for our future generations down the road.
One of the biggest challenges ahead is finding sufficient resources to carry forward the initiatives we've identified in the plan. We've got some great ideas, and we want to go forward with them, and we need some resources to back them up. Despite all the challenges in Rhode Island, and whether that's big global challenges like climate change or local challenges like a tough economy, I feel very hopeful. And the Shellfish Management Plan has increased that feeling of optimism, in part because we've had a community of people, all different types of people, come together to talk about what's important in Rhode Island and how we can work together to improve relationships and improve the economic climate, specifically around shellfish. And shellfish are something that everyone relates to. They're delicious. I love oysters and clams, mussels. But they're also really important to our economy, both for growers and for harvesters. So I think by increasing and promoting a local resource that's important for the economy and the environment, that's a good antidote to addressing some of the ills that are in front of us.